Hi, I'm Lane with Crafty Life Mom, and this video is all about craft cutting machines. So one of the biggest questions that I get when someone is in the market looking for a craft cutting machine or they are new to crafting, they will always ask me, which crafting machine do they get? Do they get the Cricut or do they get the Silhouette? And my response almost every single time to them is, it depends. And so what I'm going to do today is go through the differences of these two machines to kind of help you decide which machine is right for you. Now, just to give you a little bit of background of my crafting history and my use of these machines, I've been crafting for a very long time. I own both of these machines and I use them for different things and different projects. In the very beginning, about 9-ish years ago, I got my first Cricut machine. It was the first generation Cricut, and that Cricut machine had cartridges that you had to use that you plugged in, and it was preloaded with designs that had certain buttons that you had to push in order to print that design. And it would cut the design actually either on scrapbook paper or like your regular craft paper, and almost was like die cuts. And people either made cards or did scrapbooking with them, and that was pretty much it. And then a couple years later, it just seemed like everything kind of exploded and started to take off. And I remember I was on bed rest when I was waiting for my twins to come, and I came across the Silhouette Cameo, and so I knew I had to have one. I got one of them and started playing with it and loved it because it had the capability where you could just create within the software. Today, both of these machines, both of their softwares allow you to create anything you want. You're not locked into cartridges. You're not locked into any kind of design capability, and the possibilities really are endless, regardless of which machine you use, regardless of what anyone tells you today. You can do anything with either machine. Both of these machines use SVG files. They are files that are used to cut different designs that you can get either from bloggers like myself, or you can get them from Etsy shops who create SVGs, cut files specifically, where you can put them into your software and then cut the design that you want on whatever material you choose to cut it on. Both machines actually have designs of their own in their own online stores that you can purchase them. And they also have free designs that you can get as well. Just depends on the season or if there's a special, and sometimes they're just giving away designs for free. But you can also create your own no matter which machine that you use. Now, both of them, if you're getting into doing vinyl projects where you put decals like on cups or wood or signs or anything like that, they're both great for that. And if you're looking to do like shirts, which is probably like some of the most popular craft projects that people do, they're both great for that, along with paper crafting, which are card making, flowers, and any kind of scrapbooking craft that you can get. So getting started with either one of these machines to do any of those crafts, either one of them is great. You just need to get in, start using the software, and become familiar with it. Their softwares are different, but both of them do cut, and both of them actually allow you to insert like a colored pen where it can actually draw your design versus cut it. Both of these machines are the latest on the market today, and I'm going to go into each one of them specifically, starting with the Cricut Maker. So this is the latest model that Cricut has out on the market today, and you simply just open it and it just flops open like this. They have a tray here because they have a Cricut Design Space app that you can use to create designs and then send it directly to the machine using that function if you want to. And what's unique and specific about this machine is that it has the two cartridges, one for the blade or a pen, and then it has a rotary blade, which allows you to have a blade that actually swivels and cuts. So if you're someone who is really big into sewing or doing fabric type projects and you want to cut fabric appliques or shapes out of fabric for any kind of sewing projects, then this might be the machine for you because they are known for that rotary blade and it is unique to the Cricut Maker, especially any of those sewing type projects. So that's something to consider when you're looking to decide which machine to get. If that is one of the crafts you want to do, then you'll want to consider that. One thing about the Cricut, their Design Space software is internet-based, which means in order to use their software, in order to cut, you have to be connected to the internet. So if you live in a place that has bad internet or that's a problem for you, that might be something you want to consider. Now, I will say, since I have used the Cricut Maker and have had no problems with connecting to the internet to do any of my projects or to make anything that I have wanted to make. And I have regular home internet. So if I'm like, oh, I want to make a project on the Cricut Maker, I can. I've just opened it up, opened Design Space, and did my project with no problems. So if you have problems with your internet, though, you might want to consider that. But on the Cricut side of things, I don't see any issues, and I haven't had any issues myself when it comes to using the Cricut Design Space software. All in all, the Cricut Maker is a pretty good machine. It's very heavy duty, and it can cut things even like wood. And like I said, specifically with that rotary blade, it can cut fabric and things like that. So it's a pretty heavy machine. It does a lot, and I'm happy to own this machine because it's going to do projects that I can't wait to do and I haven't even tried yet. Moving on to the Silhouette Cameo, this machine is pretty amazing too. It's the Cameo 3, so this is the third generation of the Silhouette Cameo. It opens up like this right here, and it has the dual cartridges as well. One is for your blade, and the other one is for your marker or colored pen. So it does have that capability. It doesn't have the rotary blade like the Cricut does, and like I said, that is specific to the Cricut brand. When you turn on the machine, you do have buttons here to load your functionality and load your mats. And it also has the cup holder here, and it has the tray down here as well to store extra blades and accessories. Now, when it comes to the design software for the Silhouette Cameo, you have the ability to use the basic software that it comes with. And it is not internet-based, so you don't have to be connected to the internet to cut anything out. The software is actually just downloaded onto your computer, and you just open it up, and you open your design or create your design and go from there. What's unique about Silhouette, though, is that they have upgraded versions of their software where you can get like a business edition or an even more sophisticated edition that allows you to open up different functionalities based on your designer capabilities. But if you're just getting started, you don't need those. But if you think you might be looking into that one day, then that's something that you'll want to consider and definitely look into what those functions are. And just to kind of give you an idea, one of the additions allows you to connect multiple machines. So you can have 10 Silhouette Cameo machines connected and cut the same thing at the same time 10 times. You might be thinking, why in the world would anyone own 10 of these machines? And I'm here to tell you, there's people out there, lots of them that do. And it's because they have a craft business where they need to create something multiple times and they have the demand already for it. Specifically, to give you an example, in the planning industry or people who are really big into decorating their planners with stickers, there's lots of sticker shops on Etsy and on their own websites where they have sticker kits that they make for the month or for certain weeks, and they need to print them and then cut them, and they need to cut 10 or so at a time or however many machines that they have. They need to cut so they have the inventory available when they release that sticker for the month or that sticker kit, they have them ready to go and ready to ship. So if you're specifically wanting to get into that industry of crafting, then that's something you want to consider. And I believe most sticker shops who create stickers and sell them all are pretty much on the Silhouette Studio software and Cameo system. But if that's not something you're interested in, then it doesn't really apply to you. The other thing is, too, is one of the Silhouette software editions allows you to save files as SVG files so that you could turn around and sell them if you wanted to, if you're really great at creating designs. And they have capabilities to save files, I believe, in different embroidery formats, or it's able to take the embroidery format and turn it into an SVG. I'm not exactly sure. I haven't quite explored that, but I do work in that realm and definitely will be checking into that because that's something I just heard of and And so it does have those capabilities where they could cross kind of like crafting worlds. Like you can have vinyl and then you can do embroidery and you can do things all within the same machine and software, or things that help you do each other's projects. So if that makes sense, that's a thing that you might want to look into. And if it doesn't make sense to you right now and you're just really new into crafting, don't worry about it. You'll get there. Okay, so that's pretty much the differences between the Silhouette Studio, Silhouette Cameo machine, and the Cricut machine. Like I said, I own both of them. I love both of them. They are great for doing all sorts of craft projects. And if you have a question on which one should you get, my answer still is, it just depends. I do a lot of crafting for myself, for my home decor, and I do a lot of crafting in my craft business where I create things for customers over and over and over again. And based on the project that I'm using is how I determine which machine I'm going to use. Another simple way to explain this is if you have a Mac computer versus a PC computer, you know that they are similar in function, that they're both computers and they do a lot of similar things, but how they operate or their software might be slightly different. And that's the only thing that I can think of that's close to explaining the differences between these two machines. They do a lot of the same things, but when it comes to doing or wanting to do something specific, you may find that one machine will do that over the other. And if you're someone who is really big into crafting and all the DIY projects, you may find one day yourself owning two different machines. So I hope that this has kind of helped you sort out what it is that you want to do, what you're looking to create, and which machine might be better for you to get started with. You can always upgrade down the road or change the machine out down the road if you find that you work with one better over another. But I hope that this video will help you actually decide which one is right for you. And again, if you have any questions at any time or you need help sorting out which machine that would be, just drop me a line or send me a message. I'm happy to work through that with you and help you decide which one is right for you.